Lark Distillery, or the brand Lark, I guess represents a bit of a silly dream that Lynn and I had many years ago to see if we could make whiskey in Tasmania. Back in 1992 when we started Lark Distillery, of course there was just Lynn and myself. Quite amazingly, today Lark employs over 50 people, and it's really quite exciting to be out at the distillery to see people running around busy in all aspects of production and packaging and marketing and sales.
You know, our tagline is made of Tasmania, and that's all about Tasmanian ingredients, but it's also about Tasmanian people. It's the interesting thing about the brand coming into the business is that certainly within Tasmania, it's very well known. The further north you head, the less and less known the brand is. You know, we're coming off a really low base of awareness, and a big part of my job is building awareness for the brand outside of Tassie.
In starting the Lark Distillery and seeing if we could make whiskey, we soon discovered that yes, we could make whiskey and that people wanted it. And we started to travel to places like Singapore and Hong Kong and Japan. And we found that people were really keen to have our products. So we started exporting, first of all, to Singapore and then Hong Kong, Japan. We were going very nicely in the United States. We were exporting to France, the Netherlands, Germany, Spain, Sweden, and even the United Kingdom. But a funny thing happened a number of years ago where the Australian market saw what was happening and they said, hang on a minute, we want your product. And we simply found that there came a time when we couldn't meet the demand for whiskey within Australia. And so we decided to pull back on our export markets because we were also getting a bit thin on the ground for product as well then. And we decided to satisfy the domestic market whilst increasing production.
You know, we're taking a more long-term perspective now on the brand, and strategically we don't believe we can build a brand internationally if we don't have a strong footprint in Australia. Whilst we're very, very well into that journey at the moment, we've probably still got another 18 to 24 months before we think we can seriously consider exporting. And when we do export, it's got to be done in a very considered way. It's not about sending a pallet overseas. It's about key markets internationally, and it's actually a city by city strategy where we can help build advocacy for the brand and establish, I guess, flagship markets where the brand is recognised and understood, as opposed to sending stock over that gets lost in what is essentially a pretty huge global market for whiskey. Certainly the support that we've got from federal and state government in the past for exporting has been instrumental in getting Lark to the point that it is today. Whilst we're not exporting at the moment, the business wouldn't be here today without that support in the past. Lark's a really great brand because of the pioneering spirit which Bill Lark established from the very beginning. And it might not necessarily be exactly what he set out for it to be back in 1992, but that pioneering spirit gives us the ability to stretch the brand in so many different ways, whether that's within Australia, whether that's internationally, or whether that's in terms of the portfolio and the way we approach it. You know, we've got ambitions to be the Penfolds of Australian whiskey, which is pretty bold, but we absolutely think that that's achievable for us, and it wouldn't be if we didn't have that pioneering spirit.